If you've spent any time with foresters from the Northeast, you've probably heard us grumble about beech. So you might be thinking, you know, beech is a native tree species, beech nuts are really valuable food for wildlife, what's the problem? And the answer is that, like many things in forest, it's complicated. People have done reconstructions of what our forests looked like prior to European colonization. In Vermont, beech was probably the most common tree species in the state. In Chittenden County, Vermont, where I'm located, it was by far the most common tree species, accounting for between 40 to 60% of all the trees. At that time, beech was this long-lived tree species capable of living like 400 years, this massive tree that came to dominate these old growth forests. One can only imagine how incredibly important beech trees were to all of the native species that lived here, who sort of wove their lives around this tree species. In the 1800s, almost all of Vermont's forests were cleared, many of them maintained as pastures for a century or more. Beech is a slow-growing, shade-tolerant tree species, and so even once those pastures were abandoned and forests started to recolonize Vermont in the 20th century, beech isn't the kind of species that can just come right in and take over. In the early 1900s, a non-native pathogen that we call the beech blight or beech bark disease was introduced into North America. By the mid to late 1900s, beech bark disease, which is the combination of this fungus and this little scale insect, was pretty much ubiquitous throughout the forests of Vermont. When I learned to identify beech trees, I learned that they had elephant skin bark. So bark as smooth and as gray as the skin of an elephant. And you can still find some beech trees like this one here that have bark that's like that. But most beech trees have bark that looks more like this. So beech bark disease attacks that smooth gray elephant skin bark and creates all these pock marks and cracks and eventually kills the tree. As a result, this tree species that used to be capable of living 400 years and being this sort of long-lived dominant component of a lot of our forests now lives to be like 40, 60 years old. Part of the reason that beech is seen as such like a weed species is because 99% of the time, it's never gonna be a healthy tree. The other reason is because of beech's ability to sprout. When beech trees start to die or get stressed, what they do is they produce these clones, these sprouts from their root system. It's actually a really ingenious adaptation that can sort of keep them alive forever. However, the problem is that today, because of beech bark disease, beech is stressed out all the time. And so it's always producing these root sprouts and just filling the understory with this monoculture of these clones that will never be healthy trees. The other thing that plays into this sort of weediness of beech today is deer browse. When we have too many deer in our landscape, they'll browse certain tree species and certain plants that they like to eat, and they'll leave other ones alone. And it happens that beech is one of those trees that they really don't like to eat. So what they'll do is essentially weed around all of those beech clones, furthering this monoculture of beech. We can and often do end up in this position where the only tree species that it seems like we can grow is beech, which is a tree species that was historically important, but now as a result of beech bark disease, isn't really able to fulfill its historic role. And in fact, stands in the way of the forest being healthy. And sometimes it seems like we do all these things to try and encourage regeneration, to try and encourage forests to be more diverse, to promote wildlife habitat, and the only thing that we can do is to regenerate more beech. And so what do we do about it? When I find a relatively clean beech tree with pretty smooth bark, like the one behind me, that's a tree that I actually want to promote. I want to promote these healthy beech trees in the hope that they have some genetic resistance to beech bark disease and that future generations will also have that resistance, and so that eventually we'll be able to have healthy beech in our forests again as the rule rather than the exception. Other things that we can do to discourage beech sprouting and to promote a diversity of other species. Control deer populations by killing deer, especially antlerless deer. When we do have regeneration of other species besides beech, we can also protect that regeneration either by installing tree tubes or fencing around individual seedlings or pockets of seedlings, and or by creating big jumbled mess of trees and treetops when we manage a forest, which will make it so that it's not easy for deer to actually physically get at those seedlings. We can also create larger openings. Beech, again, is a shade tolerant tree species, so it tends to be less competitive in the open. So if you create bigger openings, there's a better chance that we'll get regeneration of some other species besides beech. And we can make beech even less likely to sprout if we time those harvests for the late summer. I spend so much time and energy thinking about dealing with cutting, controlling beech. And then I remind myself often that actually beech is one of my favorite tree species. My goal is not to eradicate beech. My goal is to have forests that are healthy and diverse and resilient, that have habitat for all of our native wildlife, that support the entirety of our biodiversity.